Cairo's Tahrir Square is still full of protesters despite promises from leaders that they will go home. They're waiting for the military to announce a timetable for democracy. 10's Brett Mason reports from Cairo on the day Egyptians began looking forward to a future without President Mubarak.
A spectacular sunrise drew hundreds of thousands of Egyptians to Liberation Square to bask in their newfound freedom. They turned up by the carload, armed only with brooms and buckets. After clearing out the president today, protesters cleaned up the capital.
I'm cleaning my country. I'm so excited. Finally, there is democracy. Everybody loves each other.
From train stations to footpaths, even the gutters were given a fresh coat of paint.
We needed to clean up the country because finally we feel we own it, you know. We finally feel this is our streets and we want to enjoy Egypt. We've never enjoyed it before.
As the barricades came crashing down for good, a giant banner bearing more than 300 names reminded protesters this day had come at a cost. The military has promised those deaths won't be in vain, with a full transition to democracy. But for now, the main priority is getting Egypt moving.
Before this historic uprising, these were the pictures Egypt was famous for. Tourism is this country's second biggest industry, and restoring that tourist-friendly image is vital in its recovery.
In Giza, the streets and sand dunes remain deserted. Our tour was the first Mohammed has led in more than a fortnight. He's just one of many begging travellers to return.
Everything very good now. Everything very good now.
While many of these protesters will return to work on Monday, for many, Tahrir Square has become their home. So for now, the tent city remains until the revolution is complete. In Cairo, Brett Mason, 10 News.